step. We're gonna section the hair into four sections. The only reason why we're doing this is to make the application process easier for you. So don't worry if it's slightly off to the side or if your part's a little bit crooked. This is just so that you're not trying to apply color to your whole head at once. We're gonna take it quadrant by quadrant, okay? So I'm gonna use a comb and I'm going to hold the comb flat to the forehead and just go straight back. And that's how I like to make a part. You can see there's the part there. If that doesn't feel natural to you and you have another way that you want to part your hair, please feel free to do it that way. This is just a recommendation. It's not how you have to do it. Once you go all the way from the back or from the front to the back, you're then going to take this half and divide it in half again by going from the top of the head to the top of the ear. And then you'll take one section and you're going to clip it with a hair clip. So you'll have a hair clip like this. You're going to go ahead and clip that on there. And then we're going to do let me work like you work. Go ahead and finish clipping off this front piece. And you can make it into a little bun. If your hair is really short and you can't get your hair into these four sections, that's totally okay. I'm going to walk you through how you can section your hair without using clips. But for those of you that have long hair, do this step. It'll just make you feel like you have a little bit more control. Okay. Now we're going to go through and section off this next section. Da, 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 da. Do you guys miss me singing to you while I'm doing your hair? Okay. So we'll clip all this together and then we'll do the final clip here. Okay. So now once that is all said and done, we are going to apply a base cream to the hair if you have it. Now, I don't typically do this step in the salon because I want to be able to get all those little tiny baby hairs, but I also recognize that when you're doing your hair at home, you're not going to be as precise as I am in the salon, and it's very likely that you're going to end up with hair color that's lower than you typically have it. So what I want you to do is I want you to take your hair, I know you already have it back, but like really stretch it tight at your hairline and take a really good look. And where you have only skin and no hair, take some chapstick or Vaseline and apply it all the way around the hairline. And don't forget to get the tops of your ears, because it's very common that people will apply color here. And then when the hair falls on top of it, they end up coloring their ear by mistake. So try to avoid that. And then you'll want to come in through the back and get your neck right here. I know it seems like it's a long way away from your hair, but this is an area that gets a lot of hair color on it. So put some sort of barrier cream here. I recommend chapstick or Vaseline, but even a really heavy night cream will help. And you'll just proceed all the way around and just be very careful not to get those little sparklers that come out here around the hairline, because we want to color that hair. Once all of that's done, you're going to put your gloves on, okay? And then you will mix your color together to make and get it all ready to go. Now, pro tip from me, for your color, take that opaque solution and put it inside your color, put the lid back on it and shake it up really, really vigorously as hard as you can. And then you can take that solution and take your brush and scoop it into your bowl. I gave you a bowl for a reason, so please make sure that you use it. If you just keep it inside that little tiny container, at some point the weight of the container is going to get too light. And if you dab your brush in it, I'm afraid that it's going to fall off the counter and go all over the place. So that bowl that I gave you has a nice weight to it and a nice open brim, and you're not going to accidentally make a huge mess that way. Okay, so again, that little square container that you have that has the toothpaste in it, take the solution and pour the solution into that opaque container, put the lid back on and shake, 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 shake. And then you think it's done, shake it up a little bit more. A lot of you have like a drop of this and a drop of that, and I wanna make sure that every little drop of all those different colors get mixed together evenly, okay? I'm gonna turn off the video. I'm gonna mix up my mom's color. Say hi. Hey everybody. Okay, I have my mom's color mixed up here. And so you're going to start in a different spot depending on what type of color you're doing today. If you are covering gray hair, it does not matter if you are going lighter or darker. If you are covering gray hair, you start in the front. If you are going darker, you start in the front. If you are going lighter, you start in the back. I would say 95% of my clients start in the front. So if you're uncertain, just go ahead and start in the front, okay? So once you've got your color all mixed up, you're going to pick which of these front quadrants you wanna start off with. I'm just gonna go ahead and start on the right side because that's my habit, but again, it doesn't really matter. You will go ahead and take your clip out. Now remember, you've already gone through, you've already applied it all along the hairline, so you're all ready to go here. Now this is where, if you have short hair, you're going to section out this quadrant, and then instead of putting your hair in a clip, because it's too short to fit into a clip, you'll use the product to help you keep your hair in sections, okay? So what I want you to do when you're applying color onto your brush, you're going to take just about that much. Do you see the line that's across the front? Now all of this stuff down here, that's because I use my brush to mix my color. What I want you to really see is that line that's there. It almost looks like I took a tube of toothpaste and spread it across the tip there. That's how much color you want on your brush. All right, you're gonna start on this middle part here and just brush it to the line of demarcation. That sounds like kind of a fancy word. What does that mean? That's the spot when you lift your hair up in the mirror, it's where you can see that your color was last applied. Okay, so from your part to the line of demarcation. So I go across that part. Now I'm gonna go into the front here and I'm going to swipe it all along the hairline. And when I have these little hairs, if you can, I like to take the edge of my brush and swipe this way so that when I do color the scalp and hairline a little bit, it's a little more diffused and not a hard like line right on there, okay? And I'm just reapplying color to my brush every time, and I'm making sure that I do just a little bit on the end. You don't need a lot. And then I'm gonna pull this hair up over here and go up through here. And now I have my section really clearly defined. This next part I'm gonna go through, and I'm gonna lift up a section that's no more than a quarter of an inch thick, and I'm going to apply it to the top and bottom, okay? Quarter of an inch thick. And here I'm applying it to the top of my next section and the bottom of the section that I just did. Quarter of an inch thick. Feel like my brush is getting a little dry. I'm going to apply here and here. Now, here's the thing. You're gonna move through the entire head shape. And when you get to the back, you might feel like you have missed some pieces. Don't worry about it. When it's all done, you can go through and lightly massage your scalp and kind of blur those lines and blend it all in. It's more important that you try to get this color on within a 30-minute time frame than it is that you get every single hair the first time around. So I'm gonna repeat that because that's important. It is more important that you get the color on your hair within a 30-minute time frame than it is that you color every single hair perfectly. So get it on, and if you think that you've missed a section, you can go back through afterwards and touch that little spot up, okay? So I've gone ahead and I've finished this section, and now I'm going to go, so section one, section two, section three, section four. If you are someone that's going lighter, you're going to go in the opposite direction. So you'll start in the back and you'll go one, two, three, four. Okay? Just so that we're all clear on that. I'm gonna go ahead and stop the video and restart and do a time lapse so you can see me do this really, really fast. And then I'll walk through some tips and tricks for blending at the very end. All right, hey everybody. Okay, so I have applied the color throughout all of my mom's hair, and now this is the part we're gonna go back and cross-check. So whichever direction you applied your color in the first time, go back the opposite direction and take a peek. So in this section here, I went through the head shape from the top and did horizontal sections. So now I'm gonna go through and I'm gonna take kind of big 1-inch vertical sections and take a look and see, is there anything in there? And honestly, I usually, even if I don't see anything, I just pat it. And you don't need to add any more color to your brush. The color's already there, unless you've missed like a big gaping hole. But if you have, this is kind of fun. In the hairstyling world, those are called holidays. So if you got a little holiday going on in your hair, just blur it with your brush. But if there's a big dry patch, go ahead and add more color, okay? Now, my mom had been doing very soft, subtle highlights for a long time. And I just kind of want to blur this line. So her color, if you take a look at it, you can see it like basically stops right about here. And then she's got her color in through here, and the color has very subtle differences in tone, but there are differences in tone. So if I was to just leave her hair like this, when it's shampooed, she would feel like she has a little bit of a hard base right here, or hard line right here, and then her like really pretty soft dimensional color. So there's a couple different ways you can break that up, and I want you to do whichever one you feel the most comfortable doing. Also, I forgot to mention, as soon as you're done applying the color, go ahead and hit your timer. For most of you, it's 15 minutes. If your timing is different, I will put a special note inside your bag. Okay, so what I wanna do for my mom is I'm going to take her hair and I'm going to turn my brush this way. So now it's perpendicular to how I used to have it. So I used to have it where it was flat and I was pushing down. Now I'm doing like little delicate strokes, and I'm going to start where I, about midway point of where I colored her hair, and do a little flick, 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 flick. And then I'm gonna take a good 1-inch section here and come to this next part. And I'm just gonna do flick, flick, flick. And I'll do the next 1-inch part here and I'll do a flick, 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 okay? So that method works really, really well if you have lighter ends that you're enjoying. So for my clients that traditionally do highlights, but this time they're gonna go ahead and do a darker base color and they want something that looks like that balayage or ombre effect, this is a really nice way to blend it while still keeping most of your highlights. Now, if you have hair that's a little bit darker and you feel like your ends are really faded and you wanna make them look a little more saturated, if it's really, really, really faded, once your timer has 5 minutes left, take your comb and comb it through. And that's going to blur the line. If it's just slightly faded, which is what most of you have, you usually just have some slight fading when you come in to see me. And what I have Sarah do at the shampoo bowl is she gets your hair ever so slightly damp, just the littlest bit. And then she takes the color and smooshes it through the ends and really pulls it through from roots to ends and lets it sit on there for 30 seconds to a minute. Why don't you go ahead and do it for a full minute to 2 minutes? Because it's gonna be totally fine if it is a fraction of a, like just the tiniest, tiniest bit darker. And I'd rather that your color lasts a little bit longer. So I'm gonna go through and I'm gonna continue with this flicking method. I have a couple of you that are doing what's called a root boost or a base break. Those are my clients that have highlighted hair. They wanna keep their hair highlighted. And I am making their base color a little bit lighter than the rest of their hair. So for you guys, that color that you put on your hair is not a toner and it's not a color. Basically what it is it is going in and removing pigment. It's almost like the world's softest, gentlest bleach. It's like if bleach and a conditioning treatment got together and made a baby. That's what you're putting on your hair right now. So when you're all done, if you wanna smush that through the ends and let that sit on there for a couple of minutes at the very end, it's not going to brown out your really bright, beautiful highlights. It's just going to soften any unwanted yellow tones that have started to accumulate from the minerals in the water. So for my blondies, feel free to just rinse that all the way through in the last 5 to 2 minutes and you're not going to brown out your blondes. So I'm gonna go over that all, once again. If you want a subtle blending of the roots into the ends, you're gonna do the flicking method that I talked about earlier. So that's where you take it perpendicularly and go flick, flick, flick. And you're gonna do pretty large sections. Come back through again and go flick, flick. And just, you know, have your flicks be about a half inch apart from each other. Flick, flick, okay? For my clients that have gray hair, and so before you started this whole process, you had gray roots and then this darker color and then these ends that were super, super light. Once 10 minutes are up on your timer, you're going to comb it through all the way. And then you'll probably only have about 30 seconds left on your timer and you're gonna go ahead and take a shower. For my clients that just have subtle fading, get it wet and smush it around in the shampoo bowl. And the color will almost start to feel like shampoo and it'll start to loosen up off of your scalp. It's going to start to slip and slide through all of your hair. Make sure you have gloves on for this part because even though the color has been sitting on your hair for a while, it still has chemicals and it still has pigment. So it will stain your hair color or your fingers. Another tip, your nails and your hair are made up of the exact same protein. And so your nails will take hair dye just like your hair does. So be really diligent about wearing gloves unless you figure I'm quarantined. I wanna see what brown nails look like on me. No judging, there's no judging. But I just wanna make sure you know that. If you have a really strong hair color, particularly if it has red in it, make sure you use an old dark towel because there could be a little bit of color that's just residual color that's left on the surface of your hair that you didn't get out. You want to very lightly shampoo. The product naturally has a cleansing agent in it. So when you do shampoo it, shampoo lightly. You're not gonna need a lot, a little dab will do you. And then condition is normal. Your hair color is kind of sitting on the surface of your hair for the first couple of days. We've just gone through and opened your hair up and we wanna give it a couple of days to close back down. So wait a couple of days before you put any hot water on it or after you do that initial styling, wait a couple of days before you get it wet again. And that'll help your hair to close back down and seal your color in a little bit longer. And that's really all you need to know. This is really simple where you don't have color, put color for the most part. If you have any questions, please call me, text me, email me. I am very happy to help. And I'm so excited that we get to keep your color going so that when I get to see you again, it's not this like Pandora's box of interesting colors that we have to try to figure out. So thank you again. I miss all of you. I really appreciate you watching this video and trying it at home and don't hesitate to reach out. Bye. Mom, you want to say bye? You can talk now.
Bye.
Good luck.